It's July the 21st. This is a Republic notice. It's July 21st, 2014. The name of this Republic notice is called The Constitutional Humanitarian Crisis. The Constitutional Humanitarian Crisis. We want to talk about humanitarian crisis that happens to people from abroad, from South Central America, in Africa, in other parts of disaster-ridden areas. But we don't want to talk about the constitutional humanitarian crisis. There has been a constitutional humanitarian crisis going on since 1868. Now, but I want to bring it up to date, but I want to mark that point of 1868 when blacks became constitutional citizens, and some of the citizens of several states could not cope with that. They could not cope with the liberated blacks by constitutionality. So they went and proceeded to trample and make black codes and to make life hard for blacks. Now, coming up to the date of 2014, we talk about constitutional crisis. We can look at Chicago, Philadelphia, New York, these big city areas where blacks are being either murdered by the cops or there's a genocide or funded as a genocide like Chicago, like over the July the 4th weekend, it was 40 people shot. One girl had a sleepover party, a little girl, and she was shot through her house. 50 people were shot over the weekend from the 20th weekend, around July the 19th and 20th, 50 people were shot. So when we talk about children escaping, we have these black children that are constitutional citizens relegated to violent areas. And we have a whole group of incorporated whites acting like they're allergic to black wealth. They're allergic to the black wealth when it comes to blacks. Like, blacks don't have a right to access to this. Now, they're the ones who perpetrate this, public parks, public housing, public this, public that, public this, public that, public this, public that, public parks, this is public land, I serve the public. Well, you got a public debt. You're trash as far as financially. You are absolute nothing but a trash dump of debt. And I'm talking about the corporate doctrine whites. Okay, now, you got to clean up your mess of all this consent. See, you done had a white senate of corporate and foreign for since 1868 that is outside of the Constitution. And there's no separate but equal. If it's outside the Constitution, an all-white senate, then you have no equality rights. And you voted for corporate doctrines under public debt for almost 100 years now, since the 19th Amendment, since women got the vote, she started birthing, the white Caucasian woman started birthing bond children to vote for in corporate debt, and they was born as bond slaves of debt for in corporate doctrine wars, the military industrial complex, the banking complex, and all the evils of consent. And all these in corporate doctrine do is consent evil to whatever magnitude, just to make sure blacks are in a constitutional crisis. See, they want blacks to suffer, and none is can say they are guilt-free. We've seen it all in all the states, in all your state cubicles, of you acting like this federal funding comes out of your vagina and out of your penis when it comes to blacks. We've seen this within corporate doctrine whites, the baby boomer clique. The baby boomer, the biggest debtors on the planet that has ever been. The biggest debtors on the planet that has ever been. The baby boomers who saw Kennedy head blown off and knew this government was hijacked and went to grabbing like parasitic thieves. Okay, now I want to talk about this constitutional humanitarian crisis. This constitutional humanitarian crisis is blacks in Chicago are not being protected. If there was whites killing each other, it would be some level of protection, whether it should be the National Guard, or they should be leaving cities. The governor or whoever, the senators of that state, should be now receiving funding, some of that $3, 4, 5 billion to distribute to blacks to leave that state until this state is coming under some humane order. It is out of order. Blacks' children have no business living in a state like that where is just absolute chaos where they can be just shot randomly. You know, it's time for you to move these black children into more safety. $5 billion need to go towards black housing for them to move into wherever they want to move and to have mobility. They should move immediately and apply for Social Security income, which is Maslow's hierarchy of needs, to meet their basic needs of Social Security, and they should be able to get it based on them saying they're constitutional citizen 1440. They're constitutional citizens 1440. That's what they put on every Social Security application now. And I behoove you people at the Social Security, the welfare agencies, in any state, if you continue to deny blacks and continue to give them a hard way to go, you will not find yourself surviving in the future under this new earth and the kingdom of David. You will be eliminated off earth. For those who don't serve, the holy nation will perish. It is time for you to recognize this constitutional crisis of 70% unemployment among blacks, 3 to 4 million incarcerated, used for monetary purposes, 20 million aborted by coercion, you know, black children being deprived of an education. I don't give a F about any other children, but these constitutional children, they have a connection with God's sovereignty. Everybody and their asses is living off these black children in this country. You're claiming they're 14 that has been non-consented since 1868, so what you're doing is you're embezzling and you're selling. I don't want to hear none of these faith-based hypocrites talking about some brown children from some foreign land when for the last 100 years you have had a humanitarian crisis among blacks under your nose. Under your nose. They should immediately be moved out of Chicago and cities and to come to either to Alaska or other safety areas where these children's lives are not at risk. Any money President Obama signs, he signs non-consent to brown children. He signs non-consent to white children. He signs non-consent to foreign. So he's stuck under non-consent. Anything he signs non-consent. See, the kingdom got him under control, whether he like it or not. The kingdom placed him there, and the kingdom is controlling him. Anything he signs legally, he signs non-consent to Babylon. Anything he signed non-consent to Babylon, which means everything goes to constitutional citizens. The Gentile time, 42 months of traveling, is over. And we have a constitutional humanitarian crisis. Everybody evidenced with Katrina, with the Chicago killings, with the city killings, with the unemployment, with the jail sentences, with the children not having parents to govern them, with children in foster care. We have a constitutional child humanitarian crisis, a constitutional crisis. This is a constitutional holy covenant humanitarian crisis, and it's the only one that will matter, because it's the only one that if you don't adhere to and begin to understand, you will not, and your children will not have a place on this earth. Your children will be vagabonds before you know it, and we don't need to do nothing, because the powers that be, the globalists, already got your children in Common Core. They're preparing them for a debt existence. So your children will pay for this. Your children will pay for this more than 3,600 years. You have a debt to pay. And this constitutional crisis involves black people. Any money now needs to go towards the citizens. They automatically should be eligible for Social Security, any welfare, any veterans benefits, and any services under health and human services. They should be able to walk in the hospital. Don't ask them for no damn insurance. Don't ask them for a damn thing when they walk in the hospital. When they walk in the Social Security office, if they put constitutional citizen 1440 or constitutional citizen, you give them whatever. We'll discover who is what later. You know, because you know who they are. And they need money immediately to move out of crime-ridden areas. hilarious because it's a humanitarian crisis of constitutional citizens. I'm not trying to look at these cursed children from Central or South America. If they got this money problems, they are cursed, and they didn't do their 300 to 400 years of slavery. The black child did 300 to 400 years of slavery, served their penance. So therefore, they are in a real humanitarian crisis because they have already paid the price, and they put draws on all your asses. And it's time that you stop acting like the vicious demons you are. All of you are a bunch of vicious demons because you're all in here, no matter who you are, on the black infant birthrights and back. That's right, the black infant is the republic for which it stands, one nation under God. The republic, the debt-free, wealth-leveraged republic, one nation under God. Stop insulting our constitutional writers and reconstructionists. Stop trying to act like they dumb. They wouldn't put the poorest contractors in the Constitution. They would put the most wealthiest because only the most wealthiest could ensure any kind of long-lasting of this nation to survive. So they wouldn't put the poorest ones in there. They put the richest one, and that's that black infant. He's the republic for which it stands. That's that black woman and that black man, and those, the black woman who take up a family with, she give birth to some Asiatics, whites, and Hispanic children, and they are under the Constitution, okay? So it's a constitutional republic, but blacks are the God sovereignty of this republic. Whites want the public. You have the public debt. Nobody gonna take that public debt for you. It's cemented to your ass for more than 120 generations, okay? You will pay 100 more generations because your public debt is cemented to your ass. You want it, you got it. You want your public debt, you got it. But we live in the damn republic, okay? We live in the sophisticated republic. It's a cosmic republic. And it's the 15th Amendment, that's the New Jerusalem law that blocks debt from getting into our republic. And I'm saying, I'm tired of all the embezzlement. All this embezzlement. We have a constitutional humanitarian crisis. A constitutional humanitarian crisis. Unless you house every constitutional republic citizen and educate them and give them housing, health care, and welfare out of their own wealth. Their own wealth. It's not yours. It's theirs by supreme contract. They put draws on your damn back. They pay the cops' salaries. They pay the teachers' salaries. They pay all those in Congress' salaries. You're milking and you're sucking the titty of the Holy Mother Nation. You're sucking the titty, and that's all you ever did. But you're still debtors. And like Thurgood Marshall said, there's no separate but equal. There is no separate but equal. That means that the fact that the Constitution do not have any debt and you're public debtors, you're separated from the Constitution. You don't have no damn equal rights. You don't have no damn equal rights because we're not taking on your debt. The Constitution, non-consent jurisdiction is non-consenting blacks. They non-consent, 3/5 couldn't consent to nothing from the beginning. And they are legal non-consenters, constitutionally legal non-consenters. And there's no separate but equal. You ain't got no equal gray rights. You ain't got no equal white woman rights. You ain't got no equal white man rights. You ain't got no equal Asian Muslim rights. You ain't got no equal religious rights. You ain't got no equal nothing. You're outside our Constitution. You're sucking the globalist dick. You find what you want out of the globalist dick because you ain't getting it from us. You ain't getting it from us, and your masters are falling. Your masters are falling. Yeah, that's right. Satan was kicked out, and all his stars are falling. I know, because I'm on the front line. I know I'm on the front line. Your hierarchy is falling. Your Babylon whores who wanted trinkets from the banksters, go suck your globalists and satanic followers, because it's getting them. But I tell you one thing, any billions of dollars now, if anyone who's working at any of these agencies, you're going to be looked at the top. Every damn one of you at the top. See, we ain't got to go through the whole bureaucracy, dog. There's always one of you at the top, and we will cut you too short to shit. You will pay for treasonous. You will pay for treasonous sedition. You will have a Nuremberg trial, okay? You will pay for this. You will pay. You will come under the royal court of King David, and you will pay. You will pay in eternity. You keep acting like you don't know this is a republic, okay? I don't care what President Obama do. He's locked in. He's locked in. Everything he signed is non-consent. So you better act a accordingly, because he ain't tell y'all to do a damn thing of depriving blacks. So it is said, so it should be. The word.